So hello everyone, my name is Marie, your first question of Soma Season 3. So Soma, I loved it. I'm, you know, I'm biased, I already read it. I mean, I think it's a good thing, right? Because I already read the manga. I know what's gonna happen. And even though I know what's gonna happen, I am laughing every damn joke. I love this anime. Like, it is so on point with every comedy. I think my opinion is, because it's every interaction, it is, you know, either badass cooking, sexy cooking style, or it's like, you know, really, really good jokes every time. Not just with Soma. I mean, obviously, as soon as I saw, oh, Soma and everything, I love moments. And they're like, and I guess they're sorry, dude. And I was like, Soma, come. And it's like, what? Oh, sorry, I didn't notice it. What? Yeah, like, those are hilarious, right? But also, like, Nikumi versus, what's the name? And now, Naruska, yeah, the witch, right? With her surströmming and so on, yeah. Even that moment, it's like, wow, this is really, really funny. Nikumi is really badass, love her tomboy style and so on. And of course, it's Gairu. But it's funny moment, too. The joking and so on, right? And we see that Dawn RS leader guy hiding by Nikumi, like, you fight? Yeah. And of course, interrupted suddenly by Erina. And they both have Nikumi being like, oh, Erina-sama. Next thing, he's like, he's a Goanisha! From, of course, like, witch, little white witch, right? So on. So, like, it's like, all those scenes are just really, really funny. It really, really works. So, this is just a great, great strength of Soga and Somurai. All the characters, like, every supportive character pretty much have really good jokes when they are next to other characters as well. Not just with Soma, but how they interact with each other and so on. So it just makes it really, really fun in my opinion. I watched it and I was like, yeah, this is freaking 10 out of 10 comedy again. I mean, yes, of course, it's slapstick humor. So that the jokes are great, but they aren't the most intelligent jokes ever. So like, you watch the jokes and you're like, yeah, this joke, yeah, perfect. Like, it's like, cool, you have to watch the jokes and you laugh at it. You can definitely rewatch it once or twice. And after that, it's still funny, but it's not like, it's like a, this deeper understanding of comedy. It's really funny, right? But that's the being said, I read the manga. Not that long ago, of course, and I'm still laughing at like every damn scene, and I'm looking forward to a lot seeing them doing the chefing and so on for the next end, the Kuga battle, so called the Shines battle. And that being said, the actual topic, then, of course, the actual agenda, I think it just really, really works well, right? I mean, the Soma thing, I really miss this thing, and the anime makes it better than the manga, and I really miss all those moments. Soma is like, I have no clue! It's like, I just love this thing, Soma. Every time he hit, everyone's like, have you even considered what's gonna happen here? It's like, hi, what? The rules? What? Expelled? Yeah, like, this works so well. And I think it works even better in this anime than it do in the manga. Especially, yeah, I think that works better just because all those moments and his faces and those things and every sound with voice acting, right, and music, it's just better. And also, again, in the comedy, it's better, of course, the slapstick comedy, because it makes sense comedy, is also better in anime, because you have the voice acting, it's more faster, yeah, so it just works better. I mean, Soma, I think, is a good manga, but the anime, I think anime, Soma, has always been better than the manga, because they are making food, too, so the food looks better, right, when they do it in the anime, as well, and so on. So, the only really bad thing with the anime, generally, like, a really bad thing, not this is not, but overall, is how sometimes they, like, skip some parts, or they have, like, removed, like, the Carnage arc, and they took it for his father and so on. And not because, like, oh, they didn't follow the manga, but, like, they changed stuff around there versus the 1 and 2, and also jumping between Season 1, and also here around Season 2 to 3, because OVA, right, which I've seen, and it's a pretty good episode as well, right, but OVA 4 is, you have to watch that, really, before you watch this episode, right? Which is kind of weird. So, you have to watch the OVA, that you can find, it was, like, 2 days ago, like, last week, and I absolutely recommend watching it. Doesn't really give you that much, it basically just presents and shows you the different the top 10 characters, right? Of the school, and we already know, like, Erina and Ichigo-senpai and so on. So it's mainly, like, showing the best slots, like Rindo-senpai and Eshira, mainly 1 and 2, and of course, then Kuga. So it's mainly showing those two characters, it doesn't really matter that much, I would say, for the next, like, 20 episodes or whatever, right? So you have to kind of get that thing, and did, of course, refer to that in the beginning of the episode, and that was good. But it missed out some of the context there with, like, how Rindo and ACR and so on. But the OVA isn't that good. I mean, it isn't bad, but it's like, that scene's very dragged out and that thing and so on. And OVA 3 is just like a fan service episode, so it's not the greatest. But that is a little weirder, right? And the anime, that's the biggest thing with anime. Because as I mentioned earlier, they kind of swapped around some parts, and not because they didn't follow the manga necessarily, it was bad. was bad because they, like, it logically made no sense. Yeah, that they skipped parts in the manga and then had them later, and it was like, this is weird, because it's like you skip the part with like April and May, and then you show the June episode, like the, you know, June before April and May, and the character's referring to, oh, but I did this thing last month, and that's some kind of like, but that haven't happened yet in anime, right? And then 3 episodes later, they do show that to happen, but then it's placed like it's pretending to be next time. So you see what I mean? Like that makes no sense. There's a couple of those moments in the season 1 and season 2, and of course like between season 1 and season 2, and also here again then, between season 2 and 3, they had like 2 OVAs in between there, which you have to watch little one of them, the last one, to get some context there, and so on, right? So it's a little weird, like they're skipping some parts, and it's like, that's probably the worst thing with the anime. It's like, I think the anime as itself is better, generally, I think it's better, because it's a lot of the comedy works better than animation, and also, of course, cooking works better, generally, showing the food and so on, but they have a little weird, logical, like, storytelling and so on. It's kind of missing sometimes. But otherwise, the episode was really great. But I think that's the biggest issue with it, really, yeah, like, you had to watch the OVA before you watch the episode. And that's something you're worrying about, you have to just go watch that. And, otherwise, I will say this thing, though, animation-wise, there were a couple of places that they definitely were pegs on corners, on faces. I think the animation was pretty good. I mean, it was like a hentai anime, right? But I love it. This is like, oh my god, this is so Japanese hentai, ecchi anime. It's just, this is Soma, Cookie Soma. Because you see the Hojo, it's like, yeah, like, the angle is like showing her butt. And it's like, come on. It's like, it's funny, right? But I think in Soma, yeah, it's kind of sexy. But it's so overkill in Soma, right? Like, it stops being sexy, in my opinion. It's more comedic, right? It's like, obviously talking, it's like, what do you want? It's like the boob, yeah, the bounce effects are crazy, right? And it's like, this just looks ridiculous. And it really feels like they're doing it on those sub scenes there, like a self parody, right? It's like, okay, it's like, oh man, this is ridiculous. Same thing in OVA 3, what's that happen? I watched it yesterday, like, they're playing table tennis, and we see Nikumi and Ryoku play tennis, and like, oh yeah, and then of course, Mitsu is like, oh my god, no, and so on, right? Yeah, and then the Oppa jokes and so on. And it's a sad parody, and I think it works fine. But there were some faces, especially on Soma at the beginning of the one, they look kind of still. They're just kind of like, not really detailed. And also a couple of scenes, episode of Hojo, where you kind of show that they're standing there, like one character moving a little bit, and another one standing here. So you kind of feel that you have still frames a little bit. Not so many, but a couple of, I think there were a couple of like 10 or 20 or so obvious seconds or frames or whatever, which kind of like, yeah, this is a still frame now for a few seconds here. So that's not a problem I saw with it. Otherwise, I think it's a great episode. But the main issue is you have to watch it away. You have to watch it away 4 before you watch it. I have to, but it gives you a little more insight on Kyuga and the other top 10 people. But overall, I think it was a really, really good episode, and I'm really looking forward to, even though that was going to happen, I'm definitely looking forward to seeing the battles coming, right? Seeing Soma's team and so on. And I'm looking forward to the Alien's team too, and also Aldinian teams and so on, etc. And the other characters, how they're going to do this Moon Festival. And after that, of course, general major plot is going to be pretty cool. The opening did feature a lot of that. I was surprised how much the opening was showing. There was one scene in the opening, I don't want to spoil it, but it's specifically in the opening. And there's several of them, but that's the one scene that, that's like, I would say very recently in the manga. I would say probably at maximum 20 chapters ago. Probably like 10 or so. Maybe a little more. But something around there. So that surprised me a lot. Then there are a couple of other scenes in the opening. Maybe like 4 or 5 scenes also, which are quite recent. So it feels like they're going to skip, but they might skip. I don't know. It feels like they're going to do this current or move into the arc, and then they might skip into the actual current manga arc. Which is, of course, a long arc, so they won't like finish it in this season. But like, maybe start do we have that on it? Perhaps potentially, because it felt like there was a lot of scenes still opening. It felt like quite recent, very quite. And when I say recent, I mean like, you know, a few months ago. I mean like just last week in the yeah. Another take on Titan, we suddenly had a story, a thing from like chapter, it's like 89 or something. I think it is in Titan. Episode 10 or 9 there, and like the episode was about, I think, chapter like 50, right? maybe a little more, 55, and they showed half the episode was apart from chapter 18 or something. So it's like, technically it's 1 month a year, so it's 50 months, yeah, so it's like 4 years. Suddenly it's like, what? But this pretty much feels similar here, because I can't remember Moon Festival being that close to... Oh yeah, no, I remember, yeah, it should be something in either. So I'm guessing they're gonna skip that. That's what I meant earlier, because they do skip a lot of stuff with anime. And it sometimes it does feel a little weird chronically, especially sometimes in return to using it anyway later on as well. So I think that's what they're gonna do probably. They're gonna skip after this arc, they're probably gonna jump to the actual manga arc, but the beginning of it, and probably just go with that. That's my assumption. Seeing the opening, there's an opening element, but I think so. It might be really, really good, because it's a really good arc, but I'm saying that, yeah, this is what the anime does look in this season, in every season, right? So, that also kind of means, unfortunately, that they probably skip a lot of, like, the contentual storyline and character motivation and so on, perhaps, and go more for the battles, right, instead of story, potentially, I think so. By the way, see you guys next week, and have a great day.